Costa.
What's going on? What's up, Phoenix? All-Star Weekend. How y'all feeling, man? You got us out here, man. We in Phoenix, Arizona. Didn't surprise y'all it was cold out here, though, wasn't it? I know we all thought we was coming to the desert. I had my little flip-flops on and shit. No. This is some bullshit. I need my Uggs. Got us out here, Phoenix too, man, and enjoy the, you know, I thought that was kind of ironic that they was put it in Phoenix and they got this thing called the NBA experience where kids can go and play. And then you actually in Phoenix and you land, and it is kind of the NBA experience because there's so many white girls out here that it is, what did I say? What did I say? Did I say something? Welcome to Phoenix. No, man, it's a good time though. I was concerned though when you first got off, they didn't really have a lot of banners or nothing up, did they? It was like one banner at gate 8. You didn't know where you was. You might have thought you was in Albuquerque or some shit. And then you like, now you know, look, oh, Albuquerque in the house. Keep it gangsta. Real thugs from Albuquerque. That's where the Alamo and shit. They do it. Gotta shout out my dog, Big Shaquille O'Neal. We doing this thing. Lovely wife, Shawnee, how you doing, baby? We doing this thing together, me and Shaq. We got together. We like, dog, we gonna do something for the weekend, you know. We like, said, let's do this comedy thing. And I was like, all right. And he was like, cool. And I was like, damn, so you gonna say something? He was like, nah. You know, so that's how that went. You know, so he's doing his part right now. He ain't saying a damn thing this evening. I like the beard, Shaq. And Shaq got all them names. You know, he the big cactus. The big Aristotle. He ain't grew that beard. He over there looking like the big Byron Davis right now. Nigga, that. Nigga, like, remember Byron Davis had that big ass beard? That's how your ass look. That's my dog, though. Shaq been that big for a long time, though. I mean, you know, he was born like 6'1". Nigga, baby shoe is an 11. Got them hanging across the window, like. Sometime in life, you wish you was that tall, but in, you know, it's others, I don't know if I would want to be that damn big. I don't know, I wouldn't want to raise nobody that big. I don't know if I would have, you know, had no big ass kid every time, daddy, I'm hungry, you know, this nigga. God damn, come in your room, can I borrow your church shoes? I got an assembly at school tomorrow. What? It's thunderstorming outside. Ooh, can I get in the bed with y'all? I'm scared. Nigga, you'll get your big ass out of here. But I'm 8. Michael Phelps and smoking that weed, nigga. You know you ain't supposed to smoke and swim. Everybody know that shit. But when you think about it, he deserve an extra medal for that shit, because you do everything slow when you high. This nigga was actually going faster. He must have had some of that ooh-wee. See, that is terrible that so many people know what ooh-wee is. No. Got A-Rod on the steroids. Damn, A-Rod. I wasn't even really tripping off baseball because a lot of baseball players been on that shit. I mean, you know, I ain't really going to point nobody out. But, you know, I mean, I saw Barry Bonds one time in life. And this thing got a big ass head, dog. I'm just saying, anytime you gotta wear a button-up wife beater, nigga, yo shit, nigga. When you gotta go to Pottery Barn to get a straw hat, nigga, is I'm just saying, you know, lower the dosage. And my president is black, man. Y'all gotta give it up for president Barack Obama. Shit, that's a hard ass job right there. How many of y'all was at the inauguration? Yeah, get good, cause I love asking people. They be trying to say it, but they can't. Yeah, nigga, I was almost gonna go to the inauguration. You know the thing where Barack was. It was a big affair, man. It was a lifetime, you know, lifetime experience right there. You know, and the thing about it is that Barack, you know, came in when the whole world going on. They just trying to pass the stimulus package now, but nigga, they had everything going wrong, and the man just quit smoking. Shit, and soon as he got it off, he probably was just gonna open up a pack of cigarettes at the podium, nigga. You know what? This some bullshit right here, y'all. This is gonna, let me just say. You gotta love the first family. They beautiful, man. They beautiful. It's kind of, you know. I was saying it was a good thing, though, that Barack had little girls, because, you know, they don't have to come under the same degree of scrutiny if he had a little boy. Can you imagine growing up Barack Obama Jr.? You had to have your shit together. You couldn't even have a construction company, nigga. And you'd be like, that's all you do is construction, nigga? Barack Obama Jr., you can't be in the club making it rain, nigga. You can't. Everybody like, look at Barack Obama Jr. over there acting a damn fool. Man, you can't go to Walgreens in the middle of the night walking on the back of your house shoes and shit. Talking about, hey, where y'all toothpaste at? Girl, that was Barack Obama Jr. It was good, though. We got a new damn president, man. It was good because, you know, it was a lot. It was no fanfare at all for George W.